A highway turned into a parking lot near Dallas this morning. The rain's coming down so fast, the freeway turning into a lake. And a desperate rescue mission for a police officer stuck in the same downpour. A helicopter pulls him to safety. Same story in Oklahoma, where water rushed in, taking cars with it.
We didn't know that this was a flood zone. Now my car is all drowned.
Cars are one thing, but check out these homes in Liberty, Texas, surrounded entirely by water. And folks in the rural community forced to herd animals through the marsh using an airboat. And just as some communities clean up the mess that left hundreds of houses in ruins, authorities fear the worst may not be over.
I would like to say that it is, but I'm not sure that the worst is over because of the way that the weather is running, and we are so saturated in almost all parts of Texas.
Homeowners in Houston clearing away the soaked furniture and belongings destroyed by a rushing wall of water.
We need a place to live, so we have to find that so that we're not moving around a lot. Right now, we're just relying on friends.
I saw the emails last night.
One of the victims includes Steve Vetrano, the CEO of the Houston Red Cross, now facing his own personal disaster.
You told me the hardest thing about going through all of this is that you can't do your job today.
That's correct. It feels very displaced to not be able to be helping to lead the disaster response here in Houston when I know that our community is in need and I'm here doing my own cleanup here.